So in determinants, first we'll studied about what is determinant, right? So why we have to find the determinant? So using the determinant, we can find out whether inverse of function, and whether the inverse of function is there or not, we can find out from the determinant and solution for the equations. So equations also we can find the solution using determinant in an easy way, right? So that is the purpose of determinant. Okay, so how we can represent this determinant A, or det A, det of A, or the modulus symbol, that is a determinant symbol. So we can write like this also. So this is the way we have to denote the determinant. Okay, how we can find the determinant value? First, for 2 cross 2 matrix, so we have to do the cross multiply and we have to subtract. So 2 steps only. So A into D minus of B into C. That's all. So this is how we can find the determinant of 2 cross 2 matrix. Okay. So just cross multiplication and you have to subtract. Next, find determinant of A. So here one example, 3, 2, 1, 4. So 3 into 4, 12, 12 minus 2, 10. So the determinant value of matrix A is 10. How we can, for 3 cross 3 matrix, how we can do? So 3 cross 3 matrix, you have to listen carefully. Okay, so for 3 cross 3, if we are going to find, so any row or column you can take, okay? So any row or any column, any row or any column you can take, but all the elements you have to consider if you are taking any row or column. So first I'll take this row, okay? So what you have to do is, first that number we have to write 1. So because for this number I'm going to calculate 1 into, if you hide the corresponding row and column, the remaining matrix will be there, no? So that determinant you have to find. So 3, 0, 1, 0, that determinant value. So determinant value means cross multiply, right? And for the second term, 2. So similarly here 2 you have to write, and the corresponding row and column you have to hide, and the remaining term you have to write as a determinant, minus 1, 0, 4, 0. Next, for 4. So, 4 we have to write, the corresponding row and column you have to hide, and the remaining terms, minus 1, 3, 4, 1. Here, in the middle term alone, you have to insert minus symbol. Okay, so don't forget. So, whatever, here if you take this, if you take this one, okay, so this middle number you have to take as a minus. So minus of minus 1. Okay, so for 3 cross 3 matrix, so what I said, so in this part only you have to insert minus. So you can say as the position of each element you know, right? This is 1, 1. This is a 1, 1. Okay, this is 1, 2. This is 1, 3. That means in a row 1, column 3. Correct? So if you add the position 1, 1, so you will get 2, even number. So for odd number only, you have to give a minus. Okay, so like this, if you check here and here and here. So this 4 part, so any row and any column if you take, so you can, you have to, in the middle number, you have to insert minus. Okay? And so here, and altogether you have to add and you will get the determinant value. Here you can see one thing. I said any row or column you can take, right? If you take this column, it will be easy for you, right? So because here you will get the only one number, only one element is there. Other two elements are zero. So by finding the determinant of using this number, so you will get the same answer only. Okay. So these are the things we have studied yesterday, and plus properties. So what are the properties we have studied? Transpose. If the matrix are transpose, means their determinant won't change. Okay, so here this matrix, it is a transpose of this matrix. If you find the determinant of this and this, you will get the same answer. This is the property one, transpose property. And the second one, if the any two rows or columns are interchanged, means the determinant value, the sign value only will be changed. Okay, so other things will be same only. And property 3, any two rows or columns are determinant of identical. So here this row and this row are equal, correct? So then the determinant value will be 0. Okay, any row or column. Fourth property, if each element of row or for a determinant is multiplied by a constant k, then its value will be multiplied by k. So here this is our matrix. Here, if in the first row, so if you take any row or column, the constant number is multiplied in each element of the row. So ka1, kb1, kc1. Then you can find the determinant value of this matrix. Then you can multiply with the k value alone. Okay. The next property is, if some or all elements of row or column of determinant are expressed as sum of two or more terms, then the determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. So here you see, so here a1 plus lambda 1. In all the elements in the first row, the lambda 1 are added, right? So you can find, you can separate this matrix like this. So a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3, right? The second matrix, lambda 1, b1, c1, lambda 2, b2, c2. Because sometimes the numbers may be here will be high, right? So by doing this, you can find the calculation fastly. This is the property 5. The sixth property is the same thing only, somewhat different. So here for the first row, you consider that the constant k is multiplied. So some c1, c2, c3 are added to the first row of element, right? But that element has multiplied by the constant k. So here how we can write? So for an example I have given. So here if you see the 65, 75, 86, I can write as 9 into 7 plus 2, 9 into 8 plus 3, 75. 86 is 9 into 9 plus 5. So these are the added elements, right? And this constant is k. So for this type of problem, you can find first this number. So first two column is same, and the added element is there, no, so 2, 3, 5. Then plus 9 is a constant for all the elements, right? So 9 into this two column and this column, 7, 8, 9. So like this, you can split and you can find the matrix separately, then you can add together. So it will save your time. Okay. So this sixth property we have studied in a last class, correct? Okay. Okay, we'll start today's class. So today's in a determinant part 2. Okay. In this class, we are going to see area of triangle using determinants and how to find the minus and cofactors and adjacent. So these three concepts we are going to cover in this session. First, we can find the area of triangle using determinants, right? So for example, in a 2D plane, okay, so in a 2D plane means you will get a x value and y value. Right? In a triangle, it is in a 2D plane, means you will get a 3 points A, B, C. So how we can find the area of triangle using determinants? So we have one formula. 1 by 2 of the 3 points you have to write as a 2 column. X1, X2, X3, Y1, Y2, Y3. The last column always will be 1. Okay? So for a 2D plane. So for example, find the area of the triangle whose vertices are 3,8, -4,2, 5,1. So we know the triangle formula using determinant. So first we have to find x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So here we know this is a x1 and y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Okay, you have to substitute these value in this matrix, and the last column will be 1 only. Then first you have to find the determinant of this matrix. You know how to find the determinant value, correct? So the first 3 into, if you hide the 3 corresponding row and column of 3, you will get 2, 1, 1, 1. So the determinant you have to find. Similarly here, 8 is there, but in the median number you have to take -8, and the corresponding 2 plus 2 determinant matrix you have to write, and for 1, and the you have to divide by 2, so you will get the area of triangle 61 by 2 square units. So this is how you can find the area of triangle in a 2D plane. And some properties are there. If area of triangle is 0, means, okay, then the 3 points are collinear. So if the area of triangle, if you get 0, that means that 3 points are collinear. So what is mean by collinear? The 3 points are lies on the same line. It won't form a triangle. Okay, the second one. If the value of determinant comes negative, we'll take the positive value as area. Sometimes, while we calculating, we'll get the minus negative value, right? But here we are finding the area only. We have to take as a positive number. Third one. If area is given, we take both positive and negative value of determinant. Okay, sometimes the area may be given and some other question they will ask. Find the value of x, find the value of y, k, like that. So that time, the area of square we have to consider as both positive and negative. So plus or minus. Because I always said, if the determinant value comes negative also, we will take a positive value only. So in a given, if the area is given, means in a determinant, we have to consider as plus or minus that number. So these are the things we have to notice. Next, show that points A, B, C, 3 points has given are collinear. So what is the condition for collinear? The area of triangle should be 0. So the determinant value should be 0. Then we can say as a collinear. So first, we have to find x1, y1. So this is the x1 and y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So we have the formula. So if you substitute this, and so if you substitute this, you will get the determinant value. If you find the determinant value, you will get the 0 as an answer. Okay, so then these three points are collinear. So for simplification, so we know how to simplify the matrices, right? So you can use this method to simplify. Then you can apply the determinant function. If you get the zero, then A, B, C are collinear. Next one, find values of K if area of triangle is 4 square units and vertices are. So here they have given 3 points and they have asked find the value of K. Okay, they have given the 3 points and they have asked the value of K. Okay, so what we have to do? So the determinant formula we have to apply. And before that we have to find x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Then if you apply with this formula, you will get the... So here they have given, so as I said before, the triangle value is given. So they have asked to find the K value. Right? So this value we have to compare. We have to equate with the formula. Correct? But while taking this number, this value, so we have to consider as plus or minus 4. Then you have to equate with the determinant. So you will get 4 equal to, so if you get the determinant value, you will get the minus 4 plus K. You have to equate with plus or minus 4. First, the positive number, plus 4 is equal to minus 4 plus K. Negative number, minus 4 is equal to minus 4 plus K. So if you solve this, you will get the two values, K either 0 or 8. So this is how you have to find the answer. Okay? Finding equation of line using determinants. So we know how to find the area of triangle using determinants. We can find the equation of line also using determinants. How? So we already know the area of triangle is 0 means the corresponding points will make us a collinear, right? So it will lies on the same line. So the same thing only we are going to apply in that same area of triangle formula. We are going to equate with 0. Then you will get the equation of line. Okay. For example, find equation of line passing through 1, minus 1, 4, 1 using determinants. Okay. So here... So, they have given only 2 points. Yes, 1, minus 1, 4, 3. But in the area triangle, we will have a 3 points. So, the another point. So, any one point we can take from that line. Correct? So, x, y. Then the same line, I am going to take another point. X, y. So, using this, I am going to apply this formula. So, xy will be the first point, 1 minus 1 will be second point, 4, 1 will be the third point. And the third column will be 1. Then you have to find the determinant. And you have to equate with 0. If you equate with 0, that equation will call as a line equation. Okay, so this is how you can find the equation of line using determinants. So So from a points we have found the equation of line. Here the next question, find the equation of line joining two points are given, A and B, using determinants. So this is the first part of the question. So we know how to find the equation of line with the given points. So here they have given only two points, so we can take another one point, x comma y. The second part, find k if d of k comma 0, the another point is given. If the another point is k comma 0 means, and the area also given 3 square units, find the value of k. So using this first two points and this third point, if you equate with the area of triangle plus or minus 3 square units, you will get the k value. First we will do the first part. So x comma y is a one point and another two points. So using the triangle, area of triangle formula, we can find the equation of line, y is equal to 3x. Okay, so the first part is over. The second part is k comma 0, the another point is given, so that point we have to find. So our third point will be k comma 0, 1 comma 3, 0 comma 0, k comma 0, and we have to equate with the area of triangle they have given plus or minus 3. You have to find the determinant value, area of triangle, that formula you have to find, and you have to equate with the plus or minus 3, and you will get the two values, right? If it is a plus 6, you will get minus 3k. If it is a minus 6, you will get a minus 3k. From this, you can find the k value. So the k value will be minus 2 or plus 2. Next one. So we have finished how to find the area of triangle, how to find the equation of line using determinants. So three concepts we have come. Two concepts we have completed. Next one, minor and cofactor of a determinant. So how to find the minor and cofactor? These two will help us to find the adjacent of matrix. So adjacent of matrix we'll find in our upcoming classes. So to find the adjacent, you need minor and cofactor. So first we'll see how to find the minor and cofactor. First we'll take the 2 cross 2 matrix. So 3, 2, 1, 4. So you know how to write the elements, right? So the first element is, what is the position of this element? A, 1, 1. Because row 1, column 1. This element, row 1, column 2. So A, 1, 2. This element is row 2. First we have to consider row, then the column, right? So this is the second row, first column. So A, 2, 1. Second row, second column, A, 2, 2. So 3, 2, 1, 4. First we have to write the position. So minor, how we can mention this is the position of the matrix? The minor matrix, how we can mention M, 1, 1. Instead of here, we are using M, minor. M11, M12, M21, M22. How we can find M11 value? So that is the position corresponding M11, 3. So you have to hide the corresponding row and column. What is the remaining value? 4. 4 is the minor of M11 place. Okay. And M12. So what is the position M12? Here. You have to hide this column and this column, row. Then you will get the 1. So similarly, for M21 and M22, you have to find. So these are the minor of this matrices. Okay? This is what 2 cross 2 matrix. How we can find the cofactors? Cofactors are capital A11. So for each element, we have to find the cofactor. So A11, A12, A21, A22. For A11, what is the formula? So first you have to find the minor. Okay, the minor of that element, right? This one. So before that, you have to insert minus 1 of that position places. So that this is the first position, no, I plus j. So I denotes row, j denotes column, no. So 1 plus 1, that position, corresponding position. So minus 1 of 1 plus 1. Right, the minus 1 of 1 plus 1, 2. And 1, you will get the positive 1 only. So M11, value is 4. And for A12, so minus 1 of 1 plus 2, you will get 3. And the corresponding minor elements, you have to substitute and you will get the minus 1. And A21, same thing. So this is the common formula. So you have to find first minus and you have to find the cofactors. So similarly here, the minus 1 of the position 2 plus 1, M21. So M21 value is, what is M21 value? 2. So minus 1 into 2. Similarly for A22, minus 1 of 2 plus 2 into M22. You will get the value 3. So this is how you have to find the minus and cofactors for 2 cross 2 matrix. Next, 3 cross 3 matrix, what we can do? Same thing, the first step you have to write the elements with the position name. So this is A11, first row, first column. This is first row, second column, A12. This is first row, third column, A13. And this is the second row, first column, A21. Second row, second column, A22. Second row, third column, A23. Like this, first you have to write the position of the elements. Then minor elements. So here, if you want to minor of this 9, means corresponding row and column you have to hide. And the remaining, you have to take the determinant. You know how to find the determinant, the cross multiply, and the in between you have to minus the cross multiply, and the two term you have to subtract. Okay. So next, for 2, how will you find the minor? The corresponding row and column you have to hide. Remaining 5, 6, 4 minus 2. So cross multiply 5 into minus 2, you will get minus 10. Minus 10 of minus 6 into 4, 24. So minus 10 minus 24, minus 34. So similarly for M13. So like this, you have to find the all the minus of matrix. And cofactor, so cofactor is similar only, like a 2 cross 2 matrix. The position you have to write, the minus 1 of that position, I plus J, right? And M11, the corresponding minor value. That is the cofactors. So like this, the same one you can follow, right? But, so here what I said, so from the minor only, we can find the cofactor, right? But we have another way also. We can find the cofactors directly without calculating minus. Okay. If I plus J, what is mean by I plus J? Position. Right? This is I denotes row, J denotes column. If you add the I plus J, if it is add, if it is an add number, okay, you have to the first. You have to consider as a, this is minus 1. Minus 1 into that minor element. Right? And if it is a even means that is a positive. If it is add means it is a negative. Even means positive. So minus elements only you can calculate and you can find the cofactors. This is the another way. Right? So for 2 cross 2 matrix and all it will be easy. Right? Okay. Next, find adjacent of matrix. So we already know how to find the minus and the cofactors, right? So from this, I'm going to find the adjoint. So how we can find the adjoint of matrix? So we have a two method. First, we'll see the first method. So the 2 cross 2 matrix. So adjoint means we have to substitute the cofactors value. That is, so A11, you know, the cofactor of this element. So, you have to find the cofactor and you have to substitute. That is the adjoint. So, adjoint, we can also call as adjoint. Okay. So, how will you find the cofactors? First, you have to find the minus. Then, you have to find the cofactors. Then, the same thing you can substitute in the answer at j, right? So this way you know. So the cofactor you have to substitute cofactor's value to the corresponding position, then you can find the j. The second method is you can interchange this side. So here 4 and here 2 will come. So 4 and 2 we can interchange, and 3 1 we can interchange. But in a 3 1 only we have to insert minus negative symbol. Okay, so sign have to change. Okay, so first term only you have to interchange. The second term you no need to interchange, just change the sign alone. Minus 3, minus 1. This one only we have to interchange. So 4 instead of 4 you have to write 2, instead of 2 you have to write 4. Okay, the second part you no need to interchange, just change the sign. So instead of 3, minus 3, instead of 1, minus 1. So for 2 cross 2 matrix and all, you can use this method to find the RGA. Okay, how we can find the RGA of 3 cross 3 matrix? So same thing only, we are going to find the cofactors and we are going to substitute to the corresponding position. So for that, first you have to find the minus of each element, and adjacent of each element you have to calculate, then you have to substitute in the position, corresponding position, that is the RGA. So in this class, so we have completed how to find the area of triangle using determinants and equation of line using determinants, and how to find the adjacent matrix. So adjacent matrix using minus and cofactors. So three things we have covered in this session.
If you need to be part of our learning journey, then there are three things you need to do right now. Firstly, like our video. Next, subscribe to our channel. And finally, click the bell icon so that you will never miss a notification from us.